Welcome back everyone to the lesson about basics of finite element method using the weight residual method. In the previous video we introduced how we assembled the element equations into a single set of equations representing the whole structure. Now we will need to apply our boundary conditions to be able to solve the problem. The boundary conditions in such a problem would be knowing the value of the function at least one of the nodes given here. For example, if I decided that I'm going to fix the bar from the left side, then U1, the value of U1 will become zero. This that we got before, by putting U1 right here equal to 0. Now we actually have three equations and only two unknowns, U2 and U3, which means that we have a redundant equation. As a matter of fact, this equation is not redundant. This is what we're going to be calling the auxiliary equation. First, we get the primary set of equations, which include the U2, U3, the unknown values. I remove the first equation here because it involves the unknown reaction. I haven't talked about that yet. But if you notice, also the first column here will always be multiplied by zero, so it's unnecessary. You don't need to find it. And the first column of the system matrix. Then we get the secondary or the auxiliary equations. From the first row, this will get us to know what P1 is. Now, since I fixed the bar, I don't know the reaction force in the support here. The reaction force will actually be the P1 we are having here. This will not be an equation to solve. Rather, when we know U2 and U3, we'll just substitute them into the auxiliary or the secondary equations to get the value of P1. If we have another case where we are fixing the bar from both sides, so I know U1 and U3, and they are supposed to be equal to zero. In this case, actually, I have two equations redundant, the first one and the third one. I only have a single primary equation involving U2. The first and third columns of the system matrix will be multiplied by zero, so I don't need to see them, and thus I'm going to reduce the whole thing into a single equation in a single unknown, U2, which can readily be solved for U2. Then I'm going to use that into our secondary or auxiliary set of equations from which we will get the reaction forces in P at the point 1 and point 3, or node 1 and node 3. Well, this is a general way of showing how we apply the boundary conditions. However, in the coming video, we're going to summarize all what we've learned in the previous videos. Following that, I'm going to introduce a set of examples with a full solution. These examples will show us how the procedure of the finite element method really works on simple problems like bars. Then we're going to take it from there and start creating more complex problems in the following lessons. So I hope you will join us in the next video.